Okay, third question. We've been getting asked, or more a kind of statement, that we won't all be doing this work, we won't all be doing it all the time, and that if you're in the central belt of Scotland, this probably won't affect you. What do you think of that?
Well, I think the first thing to say is the only thing that matters when members cast their ballot is what's in black and white in the proposal, and that's not in the proposal.
Yeah.
So that's the most important point. I think the other point is it's just entirely unrealistic.
Really,
I think it's a really unwise thing to say. Members vote for this, they will all be contractually obliged to do. So irrespective of where the Chief wishes to roll it out, or where anybody else wishes to roll it out, change the Chief Officers, change the Strategic Leadership Team, change the Board Members, then that has the ability to change where these areas are. I think the other thing is there are elements of the proposal where maybe broadly you could, due to implications of equipment, training, other associated issues, that they may be rolled out fairly limited capacity.
Yeah.
But there are areas that we already, line, water rescue, water rescue, potentially MTFA, MTA, other elements. Is it really realistic to think that Ockle will be delivered in some parts of the country?
It'd be really hard to see how that would work when it becomes a public campaign, when it's advertised in the news, when one local community gets used to that, how the neighbouring communities might not have the same access. It's a really difficult thing to see how that would work.
And I think it's really naive. Like, in some ways, it's suggested that the ambulance station footprint is strong in some areas, and therefore won't need it, and then there's a limit to ambulance presence or SAS presence in other areas.
Because that changes wildly.
Well, it does, and also Scottish Ambulance Service will plan where they put the resources based on demand. So if there's a demand, if there's a heavy demand in the city centre and you have a high number of ambulances, it still means there's a high demand upon these services.
Yeah.
So to think that you would live in city centre Edinburgh, city centre Glasgow, and you would be content that, yes, Scottish Fire and Rescue Service provide an OCA response in some areas of the country, but they don't in mine, I think just isn't realistic, particularly when we would be contracted to do it. Same would apply to OCA Plus. Same would apply to the correspondence substrips and falls.
Completely.
There aren't areas of country that don't have elderly vulnerable people. There aren't areas of country that don't have people who suffer from heart attacks or cardiac arrest or
completely.
It's just no realistic.
And one other point within that, it's unlikely that any station will have more than one additional skill. And it's been seen that, it's kind of been said that, that OCA might be an additional skill. We look at the rollout of the OCA stations. If we were to upskill those to start with, we're looking at that straight away, aren't we?
Aye, absolutely. I mean, this is really odd. I mean, what's a specialist skill? First question. And there's no definition to that. A good example, so Stirling, water rescue station. Stirling was one of the four identified MTA stations.
Point.
So there we are.
Water rescue station.
Aye.
One of the identified OCA stations.
Straight off the bat, you've already got two. Are we suggesting Stirling aren't going to do OCA? Or aren't
the
going to do OCA Plus?
They cover and stuff?
Or aren't going to correspond to substrips and falls?
It's hard to see how that's workable at all.
Really difficult to see. I mean, again, you go somewhere like Loch Kelly, Lyme rescue station. We know it comes up in the sort of heat maps with Scottish Ambulance Service as being an area that there's a real identified need to respond to OCA type incidents. So I think again, we'll get back to the same thing. It's not black and white. It's meaningless. It's absolutely meaningless throwaway words. And where our members will be left contractually, will be all of them being required to do that. I think it's incredibly naive not to think that that's the likely.